Okay, I'm Andrew Fassbender. I'm a graduate student working under Greg Courtney at Iowa State University. Greg and John Van Dyke were unable to make it today, so they sent me and Evan Newman over there, who is also working on this project. Iowa State insect collection, it's housed in the Department of Entomology at Iowa State, so that's obviously our building there. The history of the collection, collection dates back to the 1880s. Herbert Osborne was considered kind of the father of entomology at Iowa State. He was there for something like 15 or 20 years. Eventually he moved to Ohio State, but he started the original collection. Our collection was originally kind of composited with the ISU vertebrate collections and stayed that way for a fairly long time. During the first half of the 20th century, though, we had kind of a number of really prolific Hemiptera specialists at ISU, H.H. Knight, J.A. Slater, and H.M. Harris. They contributed a significant amount to the collections. Most of their material did end up getting moved over to the USNM because, you know, there was so much tight material and such, but we still have significant Hemiptera holdings from when they were working there. More recently, in 1972, the insect collection was separated from the zoological collections and was actually moved to a different facility where it's, you know, the facility that it's at now. And unfortunately, we haven't been able to do much updating since 1972. There has been recent taxonomic work, primarily in Siphonaptera from R.E. Lewis, who was a professor of systematics in the 70s and 80s and into the 90s. And then, really, probably our most prolific recent collections work has been in Diptera. Jean LaFoon was working at ISU from the 40s up through the 70s. He was a mycetophilid specialist. W.A. Rowley was a medical entomologist, and he also contributed significantly to the collection. And then, obviously, Courtney specialized in aquatic Diptera and also other aquatic insects. Our facilities, you're going from Carnegie and INHS to, we're a pretty small museum. We've got 59 cabinets with approximately a little over 20 Cornell drawers. We estimate around 1 million pin specimens. We have additional slide and alcohol material. We have around 20,000 slides and 30,000 vials. Most of our work so far, we haven't done very much just because we just haven't had the personnel, but in the last couple of years, we've started preliminary work in databasing and using photomicroscopy to start recording some of the specimens images. Our collection strengths, our major strength in our collection is Diptera. LaFoon, Courtney, and Rowley, I think it's something like almost a quarter of our collection is Diptera, possibly a bit over that. We have the LaFoon collection of Mycetophilidae is one of the more important collections in the world for the group. We have over 76 drawers of them. We also have strong collections in Lepidoptera, Hemiptera, and Siphonaptera, as well as larval insects, primarily Coleoptera, Leps, and Diptera. Courtney has significantly enhanced our aquatic insect collections, and we're kind of, one of our focuses right now is just trying to document all the aquatic insects of Iowa. We also have a large amount of historic material going back to the 1880s, and especially we have a lot of, like a significant amount of material from the first part, like up until the 1970s. And it's usually pretty comprehensive for the area. Our recent work, in 2010, we started an initiative to catalog the museum because, unfortunately, for the last 40 years, it's really only been the systematics professor has been the only person who's been operating the museum. And, you know, it's just, for one person, it's just hard to get in there and keep work up. So we ended up having to go in to just see what we had in there. And so for 2010, we went in there, we kind of figured out, okay, here's what we have, you know. And then we started a databasing project based on that, starting with aquatic Diptera. We kind of branched out to Mycetophilidae after we got through that. And, you know, we only got very preliminarily through until this project came out. So our current database is sitting at just under 6,000 specimens in 326 taxa. Our other recent work, we've worked quite a bit with specimen imaging. mainly on groups that are under active research, which right now are Blepharis cerevisiae and Tachypterae. We have done a bit of, this kind of isn't really what invert nets about, but we've done work using a high magnification for microscopy to look at taxonomically informative structures. Midgepede, like our collaborative activities. Midgepede, it's a grant that we have right now. We're working with the University of Tennessee, Clemson, and a few other institutions looking at some of the more understudied or obscure groups of lower Diptera. But this this grant is what funded our initial databasing work. So, bugguide.net, bugguide, people who don't know what it is, bugguide's basically a website where basically amateurs and professional entomologists can register, and people can post pictures of insects, and it's pretty popular. Amateurs can post pictures of insects, and then have people who are experts in that particular taxon, you know, determine what they've got. It's hosted and administered at ISU. It's kind of, he didn't found it, but it's kind of John Van Dyke's baby. We're looking at the ways that we can integrate this InvertNet platform with BugGuide to provide kind of a comprehensive experience. And then I guess our last thing is we also have an insect zoo at Iowa State that also does work with the museum. We use a lot of the collections, but we have collections that are brought out through this insect zoo to provide programming. And the insect zoo is actually the number one outreach program at Iowa State. In fact, we're not even talking like our department, for the entire university. And we're looking at just trying to expand that program and you know, kind of bring it into possibly some InvertNet connections as well. So I guess that's the most of what I was here talking about. So.